brand new inverter, power inverter, Cobra, this one. The other one was power, where is the old one at? Let me get it real quick. This is the old power inverter that I had. It is a power drive 300 watts. And so what it does, you plug it into the 12 volt cigarette lighter plug thing, and it's got like a positive and negative like in the back, red and black, and that provides power to this thing. And it's got a power on button, you turn it on, and you can plug things into it. You know, household plugs, two household plugs, one, two, and a USB plug. You can plug three things in at once, as long as it doesn't add up to more than 300 watts. You could plug things in. Small crock pot. You couldn't plug in a coffee maker, uses like 900 watts minimum, so a coffee maker blow that thing up. So we got this one here. This one here is 400 watts, 300 watts, 400 watts. This one should be better. So let's see. Let me get my handy dandy knife out. Boy, if I was in an emergency and I needed this knife for survival, I'd be like toast. All right, so let's cut them open. I never seen plastic so hard to cut. Without the plastic. 400 watts power inverter, so let's get them open. Let me read the back of it real quick here. 400 watts continuous, 800 watts peak, 2.4 amp USB output port. And then the next thing down says 150 watts plug directly into, oh, it's 150 watts if you use the plug. Now, if you were to take, it's got an optional alligator clips. If you take the alligator clips and plug that directly to the batteries, you can get the full 400 watts, 800 peak. Although I wouldn't want to pull 800 watts off of this thing. I think it would just blow up. So let's talk about the 150 watts plug directly into a vehicle's 12 volt accessory outlet for 150 watts of power and 400 watts clamp directly to the vehicle's battery for 400 watts of power. Okay, so it comes with optional alligator clips, two of these clips. Anyway, so let's do this. Let's get them open. And then we'll say hi to peeps. Say hi to everybody in a moment. Let's turn the power off. Truck off. Oh, there's some tape here. Let me see. Other side. Come on, tape. Okay, almost there. I know, take it too long. Let's get after it. Trying to figure out what these truckers are doing. Okay, we don't need that. We don't need instructions. I already know how to do it. So it comes with alligator clips for plugging directly to the battery. We're not going to do it that way. We're going to do it the 12 volt way. I'm going to stand by. Get this out. We don't need that. It's 400 watts. Way this works, let's get this sandwich wrap off of here. Throw that away. It's all untangled. And it's got black and red right there. Unscrew the black and red in the back, and you just put them on there and screw them back down. So simple. Can't get any more easier than that. If you wanted to plug it into the battery, you take these off and switch it out for alligator clips instead. Do what you want. Plug this right here. This is the black to black, black, there's a black little piece of black on there, and you put that down like suchly, and then screw the cap back on. And you can see that it has a little fan right here. So when this thing gets kind of warmed up and, you know, hot, say for example, you're trying to power a laptop, it will get hot, and it's got an internal fan that will push out that hot air. And I think what happens is after X amount of time, they get worn out. I think that's what happened to my other one. That one was a 300, probably just cooked it out. They're roughly the same size, the old one and the new one. And they do the same thing. They got this one in both, they have two plugs, and they both have a USB. One USB. And there you go. 300, 400. So, I don't know. Alright, party peeps, so I'm gonna shut the stream down right here. Let's see if it works. I think this plug up here. Yeah, that plug is toast. What I have to do is I'll have to pull my fuses and check. There's a 12 volt plug over here blew out, and a 12 volt plug blew out over here. I think because this thing is shot, and it does come with an extra fuse right here it's always been on there. I've never used it, taken it out. So if I can figure out where the fuse is in this thing, if it has one. I don't think it does. Why would they send me a fuse right here? But we got a new one anyway, so what I'll do is I got to pull up my fuse box, figure out which plugs these are, change the fuse if it needs it. I need this to power up my laptops. I got three laptops in the truck with various content. I'm always making videos and stuff. You guys know me. All right, party peeps, let me say hi to everybody before we go. And then I'm going to do my 30-minute break, which is going to be 2 hours. Our next drive section, then our next break will be 8 hours in a sleeper.